Folks, it looks like we had a technical glitch, so we're back to streaming. This is episode 15A. It looks like we had to change our domain name server to the Google servers, the 8.8.8.8.4.4. So let's see if this is going to be a little bit more stable. And it looks like, in terms of what the game is wanting us to do, we need to visit 2B's private quarters. So let's read what we have in the inbox here. Hacking library. To all users, we have prepared a hacking library using combat data from Yorha units. All hacks that have been encountered previously can now be revisited at your leisure. For safety's sake, however, those that have yet to be encountered have been excluded. Interested parties can access this new library from the server room of the bunker. IT operations lead server engineer. His room.
Looks like it's time to help 2B get herself set up. She's probably waiting in her room now.
There's like no other Yorha units like there were in 2B's playthrough. This is a hacking terminal. You know what, now that I think about it, it makes sense that there's no Yorha units on this. Space station right now. I had to sit there and think that I wasn't saying something stupid there. But if you recall, this actually is after their first mission, where they beat the boss and they use the black box to destroy themselves, essentially. And those other Yorha units have already gone down to the planet below.
Sorry to barge in on you. Oh, looks like you've already started.
Anyways, they've already gone to the planet below to help us with that boss fight. And so that is... You know, honestly, I'm going to have to go back and watch this, because what I'm saying may be incorrect. But it looks like I need to hack her. All right.
2B, can you hear me? I'm starting your boot sequence. First, you'll want to check your brightness settings. Right then, let's get started. We'll go through each adjustment in order. Let's start by getting the brightness set. Okay, how does this look? Roger that. Oh, and I should probably let you know that this entire process is being recorded for posterity.
Oh, this is sick.
Now let's take a look at your voice recognition settings. Seems your voice recognition is set to mute, which isn't gonna work. I'm gonna call out to you now. Make sure you can hear my voice.
This recorded my settings.
Are you there?
From my first playthrough.
Can you hear me? Hello? Go ahead and adjust your settings so you can hear me, all right? Adjust the settings until you can hear my voice. All right, are we good now? Oh, thank you. Anyway, that takes care of the settings. What the heck? My pulse rate is rising. It seems to be back to normal now. How odd. Hold on. Your self-destruct permissions are missing. Wait a sec. We need to restore those. I could set it for you, but you should probably do it yourself. Regulations and all, you know? Okay, good. If things go wrong during an op, you may have to sacrifice yourself in order to finish it. So, once you're finished making adjustments, you can go ahead and close this out. Morning. The commander's put me in charge of your maintenance, ma'am. That means I'll be performing regular checks on you from now on.
I see.
Oh, don't worry. We 9S models are the best around, you know. Though I suppose we're not exactly known for our modesty.
9S.
Hmm? What is it, ma'am?
Stop calling me ma'am.
Huh?
There's no...
All right, if you say so.
This is weird.
Oh, I almost forgot. The commander was calling for you. We better go see what's up, man. 2B. To be near an access point to save your data. You can see access points on the close range map. Be sure to save often.
Test mail, sender, server manager. This message is intended for the verification of your mail account. You got another mail?
2B. Maintenance finished? Yes, Commander. You detonated your black box in order to defeat the enemy. Bold, but risky. Try not to be so reckless next time. Understood. I know you're fresh out of maintenance, but I have another mission for you. I need you to head to the surface, rendezvous with the Resistance, and do some recon.
Doesn't Yorha have a dedicated Resistance contact already?
We haven't been able to get in touch with them, so we'll need you to look into that as well. Understood.
The surface? That means we'll be getting flight units, huh? Better head for the hangar. Usually we can't get near flight units. They're way too expensive for us grunts. Too bad they can't mass produce these things yet.
Oh, an operator. With me.
The hangar's up ahead. Let's go.
Maybe I was wrong, because now we actually have Yorha soldiers on deck.
Combat model like you to a recon job. If all they want is intel, we scanner models are built for that kind of thing.
Orders are orders.
All right.
Roger. bunker to 2B. Come in. I'd set a landing point for your flight unit. You'll be touching down quite a ways from the resistance camp, unfortunately. Sorry for the trouble, but we can't risk the enemy discovering their position.
Understood.
Good luck down there.
Phoenix Sword. Wait a second, who did I just equip? Oh, he can only have one weapon equipped. That's the point. I was confusing my damn self just because I don't remember this game. Well, I don't remember the details and the nuances of the game mechanics. Okay.
Target location acquired. Marking on map. Proposal. Proceed to target location.
Put her on aggressive.
According to our intel, none of the machines in this area are hostile. We've been seeing more and more enemies like this lately. They just stand there and stare into space. It's pretty weird. So this is the resistance camp, huh? We should probably go talk to their leader first thing.
You're number two.
Hmm? You know about 2B?
Well, the bunker told me to expect you. My name is Anemone. I'm the leader of the android resistance that controls most of this territory. You must be the new scouts we heard about. Well, I'm sure my people will have plenty of information for you. Please feel free to ask them anything you like.
Okay, that's everything the supply trader asked for. Man, these chores are a real pain in the butt, huh?
The Resistance is a valuable ally to Yorha. By helping them, we also help ourselves. So no, I don't think they're a pain.
Yeah, yeah. This must have been quite a city once upon a time. Too bad vegetation's claimed most of it now.
Operator 210 to 9S. This is your regularly scheduled contact.
This is 9S. Nothing to report. Weather's sure nice today, though.
Nothing to report. Copy that. And no need for a weather report. Operator 210 out.
You don't have to be so formal all the time, operator. Though I kind of like that about you. This is the place that weapons trader was talking about. Uh-oh. I'm picking up hostile machine life forms.
Oh, I need a complex gadget. Okay.
Plant life has claimed most of the central area. big plants, too.
Report. Records show that vegetation has grown to an abnormal size since the departure of humans.
Wonder if there are any huge boars and such, too. That should be enough. Let's get these back to the trader.
Tool shop is back in business, and plug-in ship trading has resumed. Attempts to convince the shop owner to fix his leg with the remaining materials were fruitless, as he did not want to lose the only original part he had left.
Operator to 9S, transferring coordinate data for the location specified by Resistance Leader.
Nice, Operator. You work fast.
Mindless chatter drains energy, 9S. Please keep your comments reserved for mission-related topics.
Yeah.
Lost equipment. Commander, there was something I forgot to mention prior to your sortie. According to our analysis team, the equipment that was lost when breaking into the abandoned factory is still there. I've marked its estimated location. Be sure to pick it up next time you're in the area. That is all, the Commander.
Sorry.
Huh, I don't see any lost equipment here. Well, not for 9S, but in 2B's game, there was a sword here. I think it was Virtuous Contract.
Things before?
Thank you.
Okay, something's got to change here because 9S does not do a whole lot of damage. And, yeah, this is what I want. Put her on aggressive. But I think after this battle, I'm going to have to... weapons or change his chipset to improve his hacking ability. Because he is crap. Thank you.
You're from Yorha, right? I've heard about you guys. We've got a squad mate waiting in a rocky stretch up ahead. Head on over. Just remember that there's nowhere to resupply out there. If you need anything, best to take care of it here while you can. What can I help you with?
I don't really need much of anything.
The Council of Humanity has a message for all of our brave androids fighting on the surface. Currently, our struggle against the machine life forms is at a stalemate. This battle has raged for far too long. I am sure all of you find the effort grueling. But now is not the time to give up. Now, more than ever, we must forge on. Remember that several hundred thousand humans on the moon want nothing more than to return to Earth. Glory to mankind.
Those council broadcasts are always so stiff.
Report. Mail notification received from access point.
Hey, our leader told me all about you. Name's Jackass. Nice to meet you. I hear you're planning to take out all the machines in the desert. Guess that means we need to get that entrance open.
Looks like it. So...
Oh, that? Wouldn't want to have anyone getting tangled up in that, now would we? Don't go trying to be a hero, all right?
Who opens a sealed gate with explosives? There's gotta be an easier way, right? This sand sure is slippery. Careful. We've got enemies approaching.
Android desert.
These machines are talking.
Yeah, I heard from the Resistance that they've been seeing this a lot lately. Couldn't tell you why, though.
So, this is basically, there's no excuse to really drag the second playthrough out. Just go ahead and get through the content.
Understand the concept of being scared?
What up, pig? Oh my gosh. Schedule correspondence. Council of Humanity. Attention all androids. Thousands of years have passed since we humans were driven to the moon, and while the war remains deadlocked, we know that our continued safety is only possible thanks to your valiant efforts on the ground. We ask that you continue giving your all to the mission of recapturing Earth from the scourge of the machines. Glory to mankind. League of Assembly and Council of Humanity.
The weird looking outfits.
I've seen that sort of thing when I was going through some old data. It looks like what humans used to wear long ago. Certain human collectives used to use face paint like that too. 2B, it's fine. Their speech doesn't mean anything. They're just emitting words at random. If they wanted help, why would they be attacking us?
Yeah. It's heading for that rocky area.
Individual target ID marked.
This is different.
From the fires of the eruption, a god emerged. One day, the god appeared before the machines and said, "Consciousness, pain, joy, misery, fury, shame, desolation, the future, the meaning of life."
What's that?
Analysis. It is the ruin of a former human residential area. Large numbers of humans resided in such concrete and metal shelters. The structures were referred to by names such as apartment complex.
I wonder why they insisted on living in such large groups. Things must have been really dangerous around here, huh?
Negative. Living conditions were band-aided by economic imbalance and a lack of space.
Hey, I've fought this machine before, right?
Proposal. Enemy should be dispatched immediately. Leaving such a dangerous foe intact would be unwise.
If you say so.
You are the true evil. You must die.
Ready to engage.
Yeah.
there's more of these things? Old world data, huh? Target confirmed. Let's get him.
way.
I wonder what makes them choose these words.
These are android bodies.
Hypothesis. They were killed by local machine life forms.
What are they doing here?
Unknown.
It's like they were gathered here.
There it goes!
They don't give up. Run. Run. Must run.
Multiple machines detected ahead. But what's with these android bodies?
Stay focused.
Imitating human speech. Let's take them out.
Happening.
This is a trippy, weird game. Still don't understand it, even after a second playthrough. Here he gives birth to the to that male android that ends up being an antagonist later on. Here we go.
An android?
No, this is a machine.
Why fight? Is this really a machine? Damn it, not another one!
We gotta get out of here! Come on! Through that hole! Looks like we're safe now.
What the hell just happened?
Exactly.
I know.
What the hell just happened?
I've never seen a machine like that before. We better report this to command. Let's move to an area with better reception so we can contact command. Okay, this is good. We should be able to reach command here. 9S to bunker. Do you copy?
I read you, 9S. Go ahead.
Operator, we just encountered a pair of humanoid machines. We weren't able to capture them, but I have combat data ready for upload.
Understood. Ready to receive.
Hopefully you can get something out of it.
I hear you kicked some tin can ass out in the desert. So I guess, you know, thanks or whatever.
Hey, welcome back. Thanks for securing access to those desert resources. It's a huge help. I know it isn't much, but please take this. It's the least I can do. Oh, and be sure to swing by if you ever need anything, all right?
All right, guys, I'm streaming for about an hour and 42 minutes, so I'm going to end the stream here. This has been the end of Logical Excess's playthrough of Nier Automata, Ending B. I'll catch you in the next one tomorrow. evening. Episode 16. Peace out.